Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to zoom and pan in .NET MAUI Maps Control. I will demonstrate how to customize minimum and maximum zoom levels, as well as how to calculate the zoom level based on the distance or geobounds. Additionally, I will show you how to enable double-tap zooming and demonstrate the center animation. I am using an example application that has been pre-configured with the MAUI Maps namespace. I have added the MAUI Maps control along with markers. Additionally, in the resources, I have already included the marker template. If you want to know more about creating a MAUI app and configuring MAUI Maps, you can check the video link on the YouTube card. Also, you can download the Getting Started example from the link provided in the description. Now, I launch the application on an Android emulator. Once the application is loaded, you will be able to see the world map displayed and a few locations marked on the map based on their respective latitudes and longitudes. Zooming and panning in the map shape layer and map tile layer are similar. In this example, I will demonstrate it using the map tile layer. To enable zooming and customizing its level, define the zoom pan behavior. Then, add a map zoom pan behavior element and set its properties accordingly. For example, set the initial zoom level to 2. By default, the zoom level is 1. You can notice that the map is zoomed into level 2, as specified. Next, I'll show you how to change the minimum and maximum zoom levels. For map shape layer, the default minimum zoom level is 1 and maximum is 15. However, the maximum zoom level for map tile layer may vary depending on the provider. In this example, let me set the minimum to 3 by setting the min zoom level property to 3, and the maximum to 10 by setting the max zoom level property to 10. Additionally, I'll change the current zoom level to 5. By default, zoom level animation is enabled when zooming in or out. Once the map is loaded, I pan to the New Delhi location. And here I zoom in. You will observe the zoom level animation. However, you won't be able to zoom in beyond the maximum value of 10, and then now I zoom out, but I am not able to zoom out beyond the minimum value of 3. Next, I will demonstrate how the zoom level adjusts itself according to the geobounds. Before starting, I will remove the existing markers. If you want to zoom in on the map based on two marked locations, you can achieve this by setting the bounds to these locations. For this demonstration, first, I will add two new marked locations on the map. To do this, define the markers property with the map marker collection element. Inside this element, add two marker points with corresponding latitude and longitude values. Now, I will set the northeast and southwest boundaries for the map based on the two marked locations. To do this, define the longitude-latitude bounds property along with the map longitude-latitude bounds elements. First, I specify the latitude and longitude bounds for the northeast corner boundaries to the first marker. Similarly, I specify the latitude and longitude bounds for the southwest corner boundaries to the second marker. Before running the application, remove the min and max zoom levels and set the zoom level to the default value. Now, you will notice that the map is zoomed based on the northeast bounds of the first marker and the southwest bounds of the second marker. Next, I will demonstrate how the zoom level can be automatically calculated based on the distance. Before starting that, I remove the code changes related to geobounds. And set the values to the marker which is already added in the ViewModel class. Now, if I want to zoom in on the maps from the Delhi location within a 5 km radius. For that, I set the radius property value to 5. And the distance type property to kilometer. After that, mark the center of the map as the location of Delhi. To do that, define the center property of the map tile layer and add a map latitude longitude element. Then setting the appropriate values for the latitude and longitude values of Delhi. Once the map is loaded, you will notice that the map is automatically zoomed based on the provided distance and marker radius. Now, let me show you how to enable double tap zooming. I set the Enable Double Tap Zooming property to true. Once the output is loaded, you can double tap on the map and it will zoom. Now, let me show you the center animation for the tile layer by changing its center value. By default, the Enable Center Animation property value is true. Please note that the center animation feature is only applicable for the tile layer. To showcase this, place the map within a stack layout. Then, add a new button above the map with a click event. Set the text of the button to center animation and adjust its margin. Next, navigate to the click event method. Here, set a map center point to Brisbane. Once the application is loaded, click the button, and you will observe the map center point changing with animation. In this video, I have shown you how to customize zoom level, as well as set minimum and maximum zoom levels. I also showed how to calculate zoom level based on distance and geobounds. Additionally, I demonstrated double tap zooming and center animation. If you want to see a working example of this, you can download it from the GitHub link provided in this video's description. I have also included a link in the description where you can check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire .NET MAUI control suite. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.